Avulekile Amasango.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being here and sharing this space with us. This journey tonight is going to be amazing. We have over 150 beautiful, excellent alumni here on stage with us tonight. And I know, yeah. It's awesome. So, this is Talisman's 30th anniversary concert. My name is Bria.
My name's Zach.
And we will be your MCs tonight. We are also sophomores and current members.
So the song you just heard is called Avulekile Amasango. It's sung in the South African language of Zulu, and the lyrics translate to, "The gates of heaven are open, we are crossing the River Jordan." This song is traditionally sung at times of transition as a celebration of life and the transition beyond.
Talisman learned this song while we were on tour in South Africa. In the early years of Talisman, world politics had its eyes on the anti-apartheid movement. Many people around the world connected with the anti-apartheid movement through the music that unified the people of South Africa and their struggle for freedom. South African music touched members of Talisman as well and became an enduring part of our repertoire.
So now we'd like to invite Talisman's founder, Joe Pegado, to speak a little bit about Talisman's inception. Please welcome Joe Pegado.
Thank you, everyone. In the autumn of 1989, a friend from my hometown was visiting me here up at Stanford. And I was telling him that I wasn't singing. He asked me why. And at the time I said there weren't any groups whose music I was interested in. And he said, well, why don't you start your own group? And it was a question that changed my life. I started Talisman to explore people, cultures, human experiences from around the world. I wasn't sure that anyone would join. I was very, very unsure of it. But somehow in January 1990, got together a group of enthusiastic singers, and you know, they didn't even really join a group so much as they joined a concept. We needed to figure this out. The first few years were very challenging. You know, we were respected, but we weren't very well known. A friend told me that it's hard to be anything more than a niche group if you only sang world music. And he suggested that we consider more mainstream songs. Okay, well, I'll ad lib here, I remember it. Or. Better yet, I'll turn the page over. Double sided. But instead, we intensified our efforts to find and perform meaningful music. And in doing so, we started attracting people who were more aligned to our vision. It took several years. It was around the fifth year that everything came together. You know, the repertoire, the type of singers we had, our performances, everything about Talisman, and truly came together at that point and was really the start of the group as it is today. People ask me all the time if I'm proud of Talisman, especially on nights like this, and what it's become, especially after those uncertain years. The answer is, of course, yes, but I'll tell you why. It's not the accolades, it's not the popularity, it's not the achievements of the group. It's that for 30 years, the people on this stage have shown a profound and unwavering care for, respect for, and a commitment to the people whose music we sing, the cultures from which it comes, and the events and the experiences on which the music is based. And for 30 years, the people on this stage tonight, they have humbly, genuinely, and enthusiastically tried to share very important stories from very important people. Not only am I proud of this, without them and without this, we wouldn't be here today. So with that, let's rewind 20 to 30 years and welcome the wise elders of Talisman. This is Talisman 1990 to 2000.
Glory, glory, hallelujah. Sing. Glory, glory, singing hallelujah. Since I lay my burden down,
burden down, Lord.
Since I lay my burden
I'm hearing glory like that. Ooh, yes. Okay. So glory, also known as Since I Lay My Burden Down, is an American spiritual that's been interpreted by many artists across a variety of genres. The next song, called When I Die Tomorrow, is originally by Sweet Honey and the Rock, an a cappella ensemble rooted in African-American history and culture. Sweet Honey and the Rock educates, entertains, and empowers its community through a cappella music. Similarly, Talisman strives to honor our repertoire's diverse cultural roots and is committed to engaging audiences thoughtfully in cross-cultural interpretations, appreciation, and learning. With this performance, we hope to do justice to Sweet Honey and the Rock and the missions that they represent. Thank you.
When I die tomorrow,
Thank you. Next to the stage, we have members of Talisman from 2001 through 2005. The first song they will sing is called Soweto Blues, originally written by South African jazz artist Hugh Masekela, and originally performed by Miriam Makeba. Soweto Blues tells the story of the Soweto Massacre of 1976. In 1974, the apartheid government of South Africa decreed that all schools were to teach children English and Afrikaans, languages of the white minority. Resentment over this decree, which robbed African children the right to learn in their native languages, eventually led students of Soweto, a black township outside Johannesburg, to peacefully protest. On June 16th of 1976, the children marched unarmed into the streets of Soweto. In response, policemen of the apartheid regime opened fire into the crowd, killing some 500 children. Soweto Blues recalls the tragedy of that day and cries out against the hatred and violence of the apartheid. This is Soweto Blues.
The children got a letter from the master. It said no more
Kosa Sutu, no more Zulu.
Refusing to comply, they sent an answer. That's when the
policeman came to the rescue.
Oh,
Bubi,
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 Okay. The next song we have for you is entitled Lift Every Voice and Sing. Oh my gosh. Okay, there we go. Lines are out of order, my bad. Originally, this poem was written by James Weldon Johnson in 1990 for a reception for Booker T. Washington. Lift Every Voice and Sing was set to music by his brother, James Roseman Johnson, in celebration of Abraham Lincoln's birthday that same year. And in 1919, the NAACP dubbed the song the National Black Anthem, and more recently has commonly referred to it as the National Black Anthem. It stayed, it stuck. for its power in a voicing a cry for liberation and affirmation for African-American people.
This song holds power in the Black community. Lift Every Voice and Sing is our anthem for a reason. The national anthem that rings in our ears and the flag that flies over our heads is not representative of us, but rather of a nation that, even today, does not treat us equally. Our founders were Harriet Tubman, Rosa Parks, Martin Luther King Jr., Langston Hughes, Maya Angelou. Our strength is derived from a different history, and yet here we stand. Now, we ask black members of Talisman to come join us as we sing. And we ask you all to rise, all who are willing and able, and stand with us as we sing Lift Every Voice and Sing.
Till up in heaven.
Next, members of Talisman from 2001 to 2005 present E Hatta, Abeta, Apebba. This arrangement is based off the original version by Hijas Del Sol, an aunt and niece singing duo from Equatorial Guinea. Sung in Bubi, the nearly lost original language of the islands of Bioko, in Spanish, E Hatta, Abeta, Apebba tells the story of two sisters separated by unknown voices. The original recording of the songs by Hijas Del Sol incorporates the sound of the waves crashing on a beach, suggesting that the sisters are separated by a vast ocean. Whether the separation is by choice or by force, and whether the ocean that separates them is figurative or literal, is unclear. But Talisman's dynamic arrangement invokes the rise and fall of tumultuous waters and seeks to capture the sisters' emotional turmoil. Here is E Hatta, Abeta, Apebba.
Oh, come.
The next song, called Prayer Song, is a blend of two Native American songs from the Blackfoot and Cheyenne tribes. This song was arranged by our very own Talisman alumni, Adrian Wagner, he's in there, who hails from the, yes! Adrian hails from the Blackfoot Reservation in Hartgut, Montana. This song combines a Blackfoot rendition by Joanne Storm and Cheyenne Planchant, Harvey Weisshield. The lyrics translate as follows. Creator, help us all that are praying. Creator, you are the first one. Let your love come down to your children here on earth. Jesus be with us. Here is Talisman 2006 through 2009 with Prayer Song. A few years ago, after we had learned that our fellow Talisman alumnus, Dan Ha, had passed away, a few of us who were living in the Bay Area at the time gathered at a bar in San Francisco just to be with each other. Our friend, Ladady Garba, was there. and I remember us talking in our shared disbelief and shock about how it's sometimes harder to lose someone with whom you have a complex relationship, someone with whom you've left things unsaid. Talisman made Ladidi and I family, but we had a friendship beyond the context of our group. We bonded like sisters. We fought like sisters. We cried like sisters. And we reconciled like sisters at a grocery store while buying some wine. With things mostly left unsaid, but realizing that nothing that had passed mattered in the totality of our connection. I admired her, her ability to live in her truth, her self-assuredness, a drive that would never let anything or anyone stand in her way, her invincibility. Whether it was changing her major at school or moving to New York to pursue her creative passions, she was the embodiment of living one's life to the fullest and making the fulfillment of one's dreams the only ambition. Her presence was larger than life. The last time we spoke, we talked about things left unsaid. Not between each other, of course, but with the others in our lives. I remember telling her to not forget to take care of herself in the midst of supporting others, that we as women often forget to let our lights shine. She said to me, "Girl, ain't that the truth?" It's hard to feel okay without her here tonight. I still can't believe that I'm standing here talking about her in the past tense. I wish I could find the words to describe fully how much I miss her. I will never be able to find those words. The only thing I can do is sing. I will sing to hear her voice, Dan's voice, and the voices of all who have gone before us in my heart.
Sitting here Thank you. Thank you. My name is Noelle Chow. I'm the current director of Talisman. That was the current Talisman, the 30th year Talisman. The song you just heard was called Hosanna. Hosanna means please save in Hebrew. It's a song that's about adoration, about calling out, and it's arrangement that is an interpretation of the Soweto Gospel Choir's version of the hymn, What the Lord Has Done Done in Me by Reuben Morgan. Talisman sings a lot of different Christian-based music, and sometimes people ask about this. Talisman's members throughout the years come from a variety of backgrounds, some Christian, some not. And we recognize that together we get to interpret the songs in a different way. Although many of us are not Christian, and some of us are, regardless of these personal backgrounds, we recognize that religion is a uniting force in a lot of cultures. And the uniting force of Christianity was pivotal in the anti-apartheid movement in South Africa. The next song you're going to hear is called the Modimo Trilogy. It also comes from South Africa and from the Christian tradition. The Modimo Trilogy is a combination of three songs, three hymns also originally performed by the Soweto Gospel Choir. The trilogy opens with Modimo, a song of awe and wonder at creation. It then continues with Izwilahla Binklizi Yoyami in Zulu. And finally, Kinali Modisa in Sotho. The lyrics roughly translate to the following. Mighty God, we thank you. Everything and anything was made by you. The word of God touched my heart and showed me the wrongs I had done. He accepted my sins at Golgotha. Oh, how sweet his grace and love. At Golgotha, my sins were forgiven. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. His name is Jehovah, the living God. He leads me to cool waters. This is the Modimo Trilogy.
Tando,
oh,
no,
Next up, we have Talisman 2010 through 2012 with our next song, Matthew. Matthew is a song written by American singer-songwriter Janice Ian in reflection of Matthew Shepard, a young gay man murdered in brutal hate crime on October 12, 1998, in a field near Laramie, Wyoming. In Matthew, Ian reflects on both the inexplicable cruelty of Matthew's murder, as well as her own fear in the aftermath of the event, as a lesbian woman in a society where homophobia makes such violence possible. The song calls into question, what makes a man? The cut of a coat, the hint of a tan, what makes a man? Here's Matthew.
On gravel at the neighborhood bar, things start to unravel, then they go too far.
The sound of pain written on the wind, face to gray and then goes dim.
Your good heart to save.
Water is a powerful and common symbol in literature and in music. The next song, Deep River, explores the varied metaphorical meanings of water by weaving together multiple songs. The song begins with the African-American spiritual, Deep River, and transitions into another spiritual, I Know I've Been Changed, where water symbolizes ever-flowing change. The song then transitions into Bridge Over Troubled Water, originally by Simon and Garfunkel, but our version is inspired by Aretha Franklin's rendition, which weaves together Don't Trouble the Water. Much like a river, the song ebbs and it flows, finally arriving at a triumphant chorus proclaiming, we made it home.
Thank you.
The next song, O Freedom, is a trilogy consisting of two African-American spirituals, O Freedom and Hold On, and Find the Cost of Freedom, a protest song by Crosby, Stills, and Nash. O Freedom is a spiritual born out of the Civil War, as a former African-American slaves found themselves legally freed, yet not yet granted the freedoms standard for white Americans. The song insists upon attaining true freedom, whether through life or through death. The trilogy then moves on to Hold On, which begs its listener to hold fast and to remain stalwart in the fight for freedom, no matter how difficult the path. The third song, Find the Cost of Freedom, born from outrage over the Vietnam War, calls for reflection upon the lives lost in the immense struggle for freedom in America, a struggle that persists to this day. Here's Talisman 2013 to 2016 with O Freedom.
Hold on that now, and hold.
The next song is called Taiyang. Taiyang is a traditional lullaby sung in Mandarin Chinese. It is sung from the point of view of a loving mother calling to her children to return home. She promises to keep them safe within her warm embrace. The transition is as follows. The red sun has set beyond the mountain. The little lambs have come home. Stay with mother. The lambs are white and black and colorful. Have you eaten? Are you full? The sky has darkened and the stars have lit up. Little lambs, stay with mother. Don't fear. Don't fear. I have lit a lantern for you.
The next song is a combination of two songs, Va'i 78 and E'are'e, both written by Israel Kamakawi Vo'ole, who is also known as Brada Is. In 1893, the American government illegally annexed the Hawaiian kingdom and systemized the oppression of Hawaiian culture. Olelo Hawaii is the Hawaiian language, was banned in schools, as was traditional hula dance. Va'i 78 considers what is left of the Hawaiian kingdom and its legacy, weaving in the chant, O mau ke ko aina I ka pono, which is commonly translated to, the life of the land is perpetuated in righteousness. E'ale'e calls upon its people to rise up and advocates for the sovereignty of the Hawaiian people. It is a testament to the fact that indigenous culture is still thriving and that native Hawaiians today are fighting to protect and to sustain the land. Here's Hawaii 78.
Okay. our children liberty. Hey, Allah, hey.
Now we have Talisman 2017 through 2019 with Duerme Pueblo Mio. Duerme Pueblo Mio is a blend of Canción de Cuna and Cuando Crezcas Pueblo Mio by Luis Enrique Mejia Godoy, whose music was influential to Nicaragua's Sandinista Revolution from 1961 through 1990. Godoy's music reflects the changes in political climate throughout his own lifetime. By doing this, he fostered national identity during a time of struggle. He educated the youth of Nicaragua, of the state of their own country. These two songs in particular were composed for the youth of Nicaragua. Godoy urges them to dream of a better Nicaragua and follow that dream until it becomes their reality. Duerme pueblo mío.
Thank you.
Hi, everyone. Oh, I think it's right here. Let's see. For our last song, we have Amazing Grace. The words to Amazing Grace were originally written by Englishman John Newton in 1772. But not until 60 years later would the melody used to be paired with these lyrics. After countless interpretations and variations, it's become the most recognizable hymn in the English-speaking world. Amazing Grace has been in Talisman's repertoire for the last two decades and remains one of our most recognizable songs. In fact, many people on stage today were inspired to audition for Talisman because of this song. While the artistry of the arrangement is compelling, the fact that this song is known so broadly is a testament to the message of the song, the transformative power of forgiveness and unconditional love. Amazing Grace.
We've come to the end of our concert, but we know you want more, so we're gonna do more. the last song that we'll be singing is One by One, and I've got my fellow lovely members, yes, here to help me introduce it.
Good evening. It was the fall of 1994, 20th century, when I first arrived at Stanford University and had the privilege of auditioning and then entering into this wonderful group, Talisman A Cappella. It was also the same year that a movie had come out called The Lion King, That summer, I saw The Lion King and fell in love with the story that Disney had put out. I also fell in love with it because it rang true to the fact that I had also lost my father that year before I started Stanford in a tragic and sudden death. And it sat with me for a while. Well, lo and behold, 1 year and 1 day later, after my father's death, the rhythm of the Pride Lands, the soundtrack to The Lion King, or inspired by The Lion King, came out. And on that soundtrack was one song that particularly touched me the most. It was One by One. For some reason, it reminded me of my father. My family's from West Africa, Nigeria in particular. And it's always wonderful to hear the sounds of the motherland. And because it resonated with me, I said, maybe I should bring it to Talisman. Sophomore year, that is now the fall of 1995, myself, Chris Tin, Grammy Award winning Talis alum, and I sat and we transcribed this song from a cassette tape. For those of you who don't know, a cassette tape is from the 20th century. It's about this big. It's got tape in it and two wheels. And we did not have the luxury of someone who had spoken Zulu or Xhosa from South Africa at the time. So I literally took a piece of paper and I wrote out the syllables as I heard them because it meant that much to me. And then we wrote down the chords and we brought it to the group and we learned it. And now, 25 plus years later, that small song that came from one movie with one soundtrack became a part of this group. I mention it, and I think this is the most important part of all of this, as you guys will hear with the translation of this song. I had lost a father, but I had gained a family. I had gained a family because one person had an idea, Joe Pagato. And you heard in the beginning how he said there was a friend who said, why don't you do it? One person. Because one person had an idea and one person was willing to encourage them in that idea. One family was born. From that one family, many more ideas, many more seeds have been sown and grown. We have learned from each other 1 year at a time, one group at a time. Alto sections rock. But if there's one thing to remember, and this is something a Talis sister, Nicole, told me just before, is we are an audience of one. We may be up here singing, but we are all one. Let us take the message of tonight, the message of this song, and use it to inspire each other, because you never know, there may be one girl like me who lost one parent, but gained an entire family, and was able to move on with her life, knowing that she had an entire family behind her. Be that one person for somebody else. Thank you.
So our rendition of One by One is a compilation of two songs. The first song, Wozumfana, which translates to come boy in Xhosa, and is a call to meeting. The next part, One by One, which is sung in Zulu, one of the official languages of South Africa, is a song inspired by the anti-apartheid movement and expresses solidarity in the struggle against severe oppression. The lyrics are as follows.
Ibambeni, njalo bakithi, ningadinwa.
Hold on tight, my people. Do not get weary.
Ningaphelelwa ngamandla.
Do not lose your strength. For we can see that they wanted to finish us. They will not succeed. We will win. We will win because we know who we are. Come and see the cowards. They're running away. Come and see. The color of my skin is black. I am proud of it. The color of my skin is black.
I will
die with it.
Africa.
Oh yes, it is beautiful in Africa.
One by one.
And we will win, one by one.